In an interview with the chairperson of the Education Committee of Parliament, John Twesije, he noted that the current format in which scholarships are awarded favors top-performing students and is unfair because majority of the beneficiaries are from well-to-do families and can afford fees.
Doing our oversight roles, the question has been, why doesn't government allow everybody to go through the board, the higher education students financing board, so that every child who wants to access higher education goes and accesses money through that board? So, but we are reminding the country that there is a law that governs that board.
Section 42 of the Higher Education Students Financing Act 2013 requires that all scholarships currently offered by Government of Uganda, including bilateral scholarships, shall be vested in the board, but this provision has never been operationalized. MPs claim the system leaves out would-be beneficiaries who are the motivation behind the establishment of the scholarship scheme.
The current scheme has challenges because it has not served the purpose for which it was allocated and passed. The committee's recommendation of having all this brought together under the education loan scheme serves better, because people will, the whole country will benefit from this, regions will benefit from this, because it will give a platform where somebody who already has passed to move to another level is able to get the scholarship and move and study. And when he finishes, he takes it as a loan. He once employed, goes and starts to work to pay this back. So this will help. Other than having this in different sectors, and we do not know the management.
The Committee on Education is concerned that the loan scheme under the Higher Education Financing Board, which would be able to facilitate poor students, is underfunded. They propose that moving the scholarships to the scheme will benefit more students as proposed in the current arrangement.
In the country, and we said that if, for example, the 4,000 students that access that direct funding, where each of the students pays between 100,000 and 300,000 functional fees for the rest of the course, the rest is made by government. If that money that supports these students can be vested into the board, we shall have a bigger multiplier effect. Because what we need from the board is they should cater for tuition and cater for key instructional training material they need these children to have, for example, the laptop. For those who need to use a laptop.
Since 2015, the budget allocated to the Higher Education Financing Board has averaged 5 billion shillings per financial year, yet the number of applicants who want to benefit from the loan scheme keeps surging. With the current funding, the Higher Education Financing Board can only offer loans to 1,419 students every year, leaving out many other deserving students. The same education committee has also recommended that Parliament increases the allowances for 350 Ugandan students studying on state scholarships abroad from $100 to $300 to cope with the prevailing inflation.
Explain that most of the children who perform very well and access government funding, they are those who have studied in those the best performing schools which have the facilities. Not the one in Bunyaruguru in Rubiri, where I come from. I have my school from St. Michael High School, Ndeche Secondary School, in my constituency. You cannot compare it with the child who are studying in Namagunga, or in Budo, or in Setahai, or in Chitende. But at the end of the day, you find most of those children that access that government sponsorship are from those schools.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.